Welcome to American Idol. My name is Ryan Seacrest, and obviously behind me, the Golden Gate Bridge. But will it lead any of our contestants to Hollywood? Let's see what's out there in San Francisco. Francisco is the seventh and final stop on our tour, and where better for the last of our cattle call auditions than Cow Palace? Cow Palace is San Francisco's legendary music venue. They're used to crowds, but not always this big.
10 to 12,000 people here. I haven't seen anything like this in a long time.
Will big numbers produce big talent? As the wannabes warmed up, we wondered if they had come to the right audition. We found trombone players, gymnasts, pageant queens, wacko jackos, and some people looking for more than American Idol auditions.
Hey, America, you're watching American Idol on Fox. My name is David Corbell, and I'm auditioning for American Idol here, and I'm also auditioning to take Ryan Seacrest's job.
For some reason, I don't feel too threatened by that guy. As the contestants settled into their seats, the judges showed up, including our final guest judge, Brandy. Now, she's a dear friend of Randy and a huge fan of Simon.
How are you doing? Are these yours?
This is mine.
Come on, you can do it.
You can do it, Sarah.
Ow, that hurt.
Very smart kid, total disinterest.
Huge.
At the tender age of 15, young Brandy Norwood would have been too young to enter American Idol, but that didn't stop her from becoming an overnight pop sensation. Nearly a decade later, Brandy has gone on to dominate the charts with a string of hits like Baby, Have You Ever, and What About Us? Now it's this Grammy Award winner's turn to help make somebody else a star.
Roxanne!
Woo!
Whoa. But I don't think he's the one. But who is it gonna be? There's only one way to find out. And as the judges took their seats, the contestants filed in. One of the first to really stand out in the crowd was Albert Manero.
One, two, three, trip that. So, I can sing, I can dance, I can act, and personality, yeah. You know, it's like, there's four. Have you ever heard of a quadruple threat before?
As well as his quadruple threat, he brought along his family.
It's his dream to sing and to... and entertain and make people happy.
But how happy would he make the judges?
Hi, Albert, what's going on?
Radio Timbo, I love that.
What's going on, man?
What's going on, Simon? How are you?
Just tell us, first of all, why you're here.
When I watched American Idol finalists last time around, I can do that. I'm not saying I'm better than, I'm saying I'm as good as. You know what I mean?
You were as good as Fantasia.
Well, check this out, man. Fantasia was good because she had personality, like a razor blade, you know what I mean? And plus she had the moves and all that. And that's what I have. I've got personality, man. Yes, I'm ready,
that's
man.
Right.
I've been ready. I'm waiting
for
you.
What are you going
to sing? Oh, I'm going to sing Wanna Be Starting Something.
You go then.
Said you wanna be starting something, got to be starting something. Said you wanna be starting something, got to be starting something. Too high to get over, too low to get under. You're stuck in the middle, and the pain is thunder. Too high to get over,
yeah, yeah.
Too low to get under.
Yeah, yeah.
You're stuck in the middle,
yeah, yeah.
And the pain is thunder. I sent my baby to the doctor with a fever for nothing he felt.
Ooh.
The podiatrist in the street, they said she had a breakdown. Someone's always trying, stop my baby crying, treacherous kind declining. You got my baby crying.
That was good, Albert. Good for you.
That was.
You worked it out. You just worked it out.
And you all know, Paul, you especially know, Brandy, you know, it's hard to sing and dance at the same time.
Oh, yeah.
Right. And sing and dance,
well,
Michael,
Albert,
at the same time.
You just proved that.
Yeah, thank you. I know it, man.
Yes, you have personality, but dogs have personality. The audition, if I'm being honest with you, was horrible.
It was really terrible.
Albert, we enjoyed you, but it's not, it's
well,
a no.
Well, you did,
thank
I didn't.
You.
It's
I'm
a no.
Sorry.
No.
Bye.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, well, you know, it didn't happen this time, that's okay.
You're on the road, Albert.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know what, I think they really got scared. Like, I did really good, and I think they really just got nervous. They really couldn't handle that kind of entertainment personality on the show. You know, it's okay.
Albert!
Next on contestant row was Matthew Miller, and he modeled himself after a very different star.
Hi, what's your name?
My name's Matthew.
Oh, hi, Matthew.
Hi, Matthew.
Hi.
So why are you here today?
Oh, gosh. I'm here because it has always been my dream to be a singer.
And you love Kelly.
I love Kelly, yes.
Wow.
I adore her.
Wow, okay. Well, what are you going to sing for us today?
Before Your Love by Kelly Clarkson.
Oh.
Oh, cool.
Go for it.
I never lived before your love. I never felt before your touch. I never needed anyone to make me feel alive. But then again.
Oh my God.
Oh. Wow. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
I'm jealous of you.
Did anyone ever say to you that you sounded like a woman?
Yes, I get that a lot.
All the time.
Yes, I've sang at church, and one lady came up to me one time, and she's like, you know, I was sitting there, and I was closing my eyes, and I just thought, oh, this beautiful voice, it must be a skinny black woman. And then I opened my eyes and
saw
her.
But you sound like a skinny black woman. Wow. Oh.
Oh, my God. I don't know what to say. Simon,
I don't know what to say either.
Simon, you can say everything on this one.
I feel Matthew has more important decisions to make in his life because we're not sure whether it's Matthew or Martha. You know what I mean?
No, is Martha the name of a skinny black woman?
No, if I was a skinny black woman, I think I'd be like Shakiki or Shaquana.
Shakiki.
Shaquana.
But you know where I'm coming from here, Matthew, don't you?
Yes or no to Hollywood?
Absolutely not, I'm afraid, Matthew. But maybe we'll see you in the future.
Paula?
A better song that would suit you would be picking a male vocalist.
Okay, definitely.
Randy? I'm really just confused, just period. Like everyone else. Just
it
totally.
Was a tribute. Matthew did a tribute.
Yeah, a tribute to Kelly Clarkson.
Thank you so much, Matthew. You were awesome.
A clearly emotional Matthew Miller was consoled by his fellow contestants.
It's gonna be fine. You just hang in there, okay?
Unfortunately, the judges hadn't seen anything to console them yet.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! I'm an elephant, and I get what I want. I'll trample over
you. But things get better. Stay with us as the crooners cruise in.
I go, there I go.
Plus, we're short on talent.
Why do you build me up, buttercup baby, just
we're short on skirts, and we're short on breath. Welcome back to American Idol here in San Francisco, where Tony Bennett famously and rather carelessly left his heart. So we were expecting some crooners. And on day one, two turned up. We got Jamie Paul Kohler, who sells cars, and Ross Williams, who sells hardware. But would the judges buy into Ross's confidence?
I think I've got some of the best chances of being the next American Idol in this group.
And would they appreciate JP Kohler's tribute to his uncle?
He always told me that one day I would make it, and he wanted me to sing. I left my heart in San Francisco for him. So that's what I'm doing.
Hello. How are you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Likewise.
Hello.
How are you?
Very well, thank you, Simon.
Good, 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 good.
Brandy, hi.
What's up, you okay?
Hello.
You're in retail sales.
Yes, sir.
26.
Right.
And Stevie Wonder is your inspiration.
Absolutely.
Why are you here, Ross?
I'm here to be the next American Idol.
Okay, good. Yeah. What are you gonna sing?
I'm gonna sing a song called Moody's Mood for Love.
Well, what are you gonna sing for us today?
I'm gonna sing I Left My Heart in San Francisco.
That's
perfect. Oh. Love that song, love it.
I left my heart in San Francisco upon a hill. It calls to me when I come home to you, San Francisco. Your golden sun will shine for me.
There I go, there I go, there I go, there I go. Pretty baby, you are the soul that snaps my control. Such a funny thing, but every time I'm near you, I never can behave. You give me a smile and then I'm wrapped up in your magic. There's music all around me. Crazy music, music that keeps calling me so very close to you. Turns me your slave.
If you're the salesman, you should tell us why we should put you through.
So, one crooner had sold himself to the judges. Can the other?
And the people that I've met in my life have made me a big part of who I am.
Right, now we'll do the American Idol version, not Miss World.
Okay, sir. Well, I have what it takes.
That'll do.
You nailed every single note and the feel of it, and you got the vibe just down right, and it was subtle.
Brandy?
Thank you.
I think you got it. I definitely think you have it, and...
Yeah, thanks.
I was totally blown away. Definitely.
Okay, Randy, yes or no?
You know what? Because I like you, I'm going to give you another try. I say yes.
Thank
Brandy?
You. I say yes, too.
Thank you.
Absolutely yes.
Okay, we will see you in Hollywood.
Thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
I would say definitely 100%
yes. 150%
yes. Woo! Can we get 200?
A million bazillion times yes.
Yeah!
I would have said no, actually. I'm not as blown away as these three. I thought it was more style over substance, to be honest with you.
But it means anyway, the three of us said yes, so guess what?
Welcome to Hollywood. Hollywood! Yeah!
Yes!
Yeah!
I need it!
So, the crooners proved popular with the panel, but it wasn't just the old-school smoothies who came to the Bay Area. They liked to flaunt it in San Francisco. No one more so than Elizabeth Pah. Not since Simon Cowell had anyone with so little material made such a big impression.
I think the American public's gonna like what I'm wearing. I mean, it's cute, and it fits my personality. You know, just, this is me.
That is a very interesting outfit, Elizabeth.
Oh, you like it?
I love it.
I was hoping to impress all of you guys.
You definitely have done that. Why are you here?
Oh, I'm here because I want to become a superstar.
Yeah, yeah.
Seriously, it's like a lifelong dream of mine.
You know, you don't need to tell me that. You want a lot of people looking at you, don't you?
Yes, I love attention.
I thought you
did. Look
at
me.
And what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Whitney Houston, I Have Nothing.
Okay.
It's like one of my favorite
great.
All-time...
I can't wait.
Cool.
Off you go, Elizabeth.
Okay. I don't really need to look very much farther. I don't want to have to go where you don't follow. I won't hold it back again. This passion inside, I can't run from myself. There's nowhere to hide. Don't make me close one more door. I don't want to hurt anymore.
Thank you very much. Brandy.
Wow. And you're so little, and that big voice just kind of...
It just threw you off guard.
Yeah.
Right.
I'm like a built-in.
That's exactly
Do people often react the same way?
Yes.
I bet they
you're
do.
A small person, but where does this voice come from?
Powerful, huh?
But the image is hideous.
It's hideous.
Hideous.
Yeah, very stripper club-ish.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't think of it that way.
Go-go dancer-ish.
Because I'm very, like, flamboyant, you know?
Yeah,
like,
but
my
it's
personality.
Just, it's just not good.
Did you think that wearing this, you would stand out and people would remember this look? Because you achieved that, but it's not in a positive way.
Oh, okay.
So let's take away the image, the voice. Randy, yes or no?
No, I'm going to have to say no.
Brandy?
I'm going to have to say no, too.
Paula?
Sorry. I think you deserve another chance, so I'm going to say yes.
Thank you.
Elizabeth, you've had two no's, one yes. I think it was a mistake to do a Whitney Houston song, but we are going to give you one more chance. You're coming back to Hollywood.
Oh, my goodness.
Welcome to Hollywood, Elizabeth.
Oh, thank you so much.
Coming up, the look for this season.
Hi.
The rage of Victor Mercado.
I'm not all fat like Ruben. I'm better looking than Clay. I definitely think so. Definitely.
And the mother of all freakouts.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome back to American Idol. Now, throughout the audition tour, a lot of the contestants bring along their moms for support. Well, it turns out they are just as vocal as many of the contestants.
Lauren, this is the
yes.
I go.
Lauren, the next American Idol.
Woo-hoo, woo-hoo. Oh, mother.
Mostly they're supportive.
Give it all you got, son.
Hey, lady, my son sings better than your son.
But they can be brutally honest.
I don't think the odds are
in his favor. He can sing it sometime.
And it can be obvious where the talent comes from.
I believe the children are our future.
Unfortunately, it can also embarrass you.
I done peed my pants.
Good to know. But the mother of all mothers turned up in San Francisco.
Justin Clark, 17 years old, from Atlanta, Georgia, repping the A-Town. This is my mother, Debbie Starks, my biggest fan, number one fan.
True, true.
So we're number doing our fan. Thing.
My Cherie Moore,
pretty little one that I
adore. You're the only girl my heart beats for. How I wish that you were mine.
Thank you.
Simon, what do you think?
Simply based on that, I'd say yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Paula?
I think you really do have a good voice.
Yes!
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Don't even have to. Yes.
Thank you.
See you in Hollywood, man. Yeah. See you in Hollywood, baby. Yeah, yeah. Woo! Woo!
Woo!
As Justin went to find a quiet place for his mother, we had the chance to reconnect with someone from seasons past, Michael Garcia. And we went back to his apartment just around the corner where he gave us a history of his idol look.
In season 3, I just wore a shirt and a pair of jeans, and my image was probably wrong. This year's different. My image is way different. I had a makeover. I'm more in touch with my essence, my true essence. You know, a fashionista type of look. Very trendy, very hip, and very in.
So, would the makeover make all the difference?
Hi.
How are you feeling?
Very nervous, but excited.
Why are you here, Michael?
Because I'm the next American Idol.
Oh, my God.
Who says that?
My friends, my soul.
Oh, that's nice.
Okay.
What are you going to sing for us?
If I'm Not Made for You.
By whom?
By Daniel Benningfield.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Off you go.
And I don't want to run away, but I can't take it. I don't understand. If I'm not made for you, then why does my heart tell me that I am? Is there any way that I can stay in your arms? Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend, and I'll help you carry on.
Thank you, Michael.
Sorry.
Okay, I'm not going to you right now. I'm going to abandon you for a minute,
yeah.
And I'm going to go to Brandy.
Please abandon me as well.
I can't believe that.
I can answer.
Brandy.
Dude, listen. Singing. Drop it.
Good advice.
Let the singing go. Trust us, man. We're looking out for you, though.
Thank you so much. You're a good guy.
All right, baby. Yeah. Yeah.
I didn't do my best, but I guess I'll just let singing go.
At last, Michael had the courage to take our judge's advice. Maybe I can get him to give me some of my wardrobe. Now, following Michael was someone with no fashion sense and no need to sing. Hip-hop nanny, Christopher Knoll.
I'm gonna go in there, I'm gonna drop some ill rhymes on them, and they're gonna love it.
Christopher Scott Knoll.
That's right, sir.
Right, and you're a nanny.
I am a nanny. I tend after two young girls. I love them with all my heart. I call them my kids, even though...
They're like your family.
They're like my family.
But you'd leave them behind if you did well in this?
In a heartbeat.
Right, right, okay. Yeah.
And what are you gonna sing, Christopher?
I'm gonna sing some original rap songs for you about y'all.
Great, off you go.
All right, we ready?
Yeah.
Stop looking, cause y'all can't find a better man. Damn San Fran, I'm the man with the better plan. Roof, where my dog at? Roof, Randy Jackson. Dropping facts, son. Dropping weight, change the waist on his slack, son. What about the one with the wisecrack, son? Simon Cowell, S. Cowell. Spell it out, and yes, it spells scowl. Always on the prowl, don't make him growl. But recognize that you wise like the owl. Ooh, yeah, I gotta thank God and Jesus. I gotta thank Ganesha. Oh my gosh, look, it's TV's Moesha. Yo, yo, Q, you know your girl be a dandy. Better known as Brandy, and she be some eye candy. Ooh-wee, you-wee, Paula Adulshi. So hot, yo, yo, she's so cushy. So fine, I'm inclined to drool. Wanna sip wine and recline by the pool? Not tonight, Chris, I got a headache. Take a Midol, girl. You looking at the American Idol.
That was cool.
Yes.
That was really good.
Entertaining.
That was thank really you. Entertaining.
Thank you, thank you.
Randy, yes or no?
Remember, dropping facts, son. Dropping weight, change the waist on his slack,
dropping
son.
Science, dropping knowledge. Dropping
like a bomb.
I'm gonna have to say no.
Brandy.
I'm going to say...
Randy said no? Y'all are rude? Look at these two, rude on the left.
Paula.
You know what? I think he's been the most original we've seen today. So I'm going to say yes.
God bless you, Paula.
The girls have kept their nanny. It's a no.
All right, y'all. Man, that. We liked you, but you're not right. You're the most original thing we saw all day, but it was great, and I was feeling it, but whatever.
Yeah, I'm sure he's great with the kids. Christopher Knoll, the hand that rocks the cradle and the language that rocked the audition room. Stay with us, more Idol after this. Coming up, true talent.
So you're here because you are the next American Idol.
Yes, I am.
Plus, the Molfetta saga concludes.
Hello, Simon.
Hello, John.
Welcome back to San Francisco, where hundreds are still waiting in the holding room. One of them is Nadia Turner, who has big hair, but not a big head.
I actually have not thought about what any of the judges might say, only because I didn't want to put anything negative or positive into my head or make any assumptions, because we all know when you make assumptions, you make a out of you and me.
Nadia Turner, what's going on with you?
Hi, how are you guys doing?
Hi, how are you?
I'm good, I'm well.
All right, what are you gonna sing?
I'm gonna sing a song by Aretha Franklin, but the redone version by Mickey Howard. It's Until You Come Back to Me.
Oh, yeah, it's a good song, okay.
I said, baby, I'm gonna knock on your door, tap on your window pane. I'm gonna sit by your step until I get through to you. Listen, you, missing you, oh. Till you come back to me, that's what I'm gonna do.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
What do you say, Simon, about Nadia Turner?
I like you, Nadia. You know, you look good, you're different. It was a good choice of song. You have a nice voice. You stand out in the crowd, which is rare today.
Yeah.
Nadia, you do have a presence about you.
Thank you, Paul.
And it's wonderful.
Thank you.
I love your style, and I love your voice. And I love your hair.
Thank you.
I love the hair, too. I used to have my hair like that.
Really?
Yeah. All right, so yes and no, Simon.
Yep.
Paula?
Amen.
Yep. Me, too.
Thank you.
Unanimous yes. I say yes. Welcome to Hollywood, Nadia Turner.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
See you in Hollywood, baby.
I think I'm going to faint. Hold on. Somebody catch me.
There's some talent, Nadia Turner, one to definitely watch for in Hollywood.
Oh my God.
Now, San Francisco is the spiritual home of peace, love, and harmony. It's a shame no one told Victor Mercado.
What's going down, dog?
Nothing much. I'm just so happy to be here.
Got on your dog shades, man. You must be ready.
Oh, I'm so ready.
All right, so you're 23. You auditioned in Hawaii last year. You're back for more. What are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Build Me Up Buttercup by The Foundations.
Go for it, baby.
Why do you build me up, Buttercup, baby, just to let me down and mess me around? And then first of all, you never call, baby, when you say you will. But I love you still. I need you more than anyone, Paula. You know that I have from the start. Mm. So build me up. And Brandy, please don't break my heart.
Oh. Okay, all right, all right.
Thank you so much, Victor.
Should we just do this together, you guys, on the count of three? One, two, three. No.
Victor, you are a terrible singer. You are a terrible dancer. You have no charisma.
Terrible.
I mean, everything.
No charisma?
No.
I've seen some of those people that you sent through there, and I know I'm a lot better than them.
Oh,
you know,
dude,
a lot
come
better.
On.
I got all the energy.
Victor.
I got a wonderful voice.
Victor, you know what? It doesn't matter what we think. All that matters is what you think anyway.
Your voice is terrible.
It's definitely what America thinks.
Victor,
as well.
America would hate you.
Your voice
America
is terrible,
would not hate me, I
They would hate
that.
You, Victor, honestly.
Vic, man.
Let me tell you one thing. You don't forget this name, because I'll be back. Might not be back
Victor,
on this show, but
Victor,
I definitely will.
If you manage to get a number one record in the next 6 months, I'll pay you $50,000.
I'll raise it to 100.
I'll pay you 100.
$100,000?
What about William?
Really?
Come here. It's a bet. It's a bet.
I'll definitely bring it on, Simon.
It's
definitely
a bet.
Bring it on.
You don't have to pay me, I'll pay you. Right. Because, Victor, you can't sing.
That's fine. I appreciate
right, thank
that.
You, man.
I really appreciate your honesty.
We appreciate
thank
yours,
you
too.
They're That's all I gotta say, a bunch of This is I can dance. I can sing. I just, right now, I do not want the cameras in my face. I'm a little right now. I made a bet with Simon. He's gonna pay me $100,000 if I can get a record contract in the next 6 months. $100,000. Well, you know what, anybody in America, sign me up. I'll give you half of the $100,000.
Yeah, nice offer, if that had actually been what Simon said.
Victor, if you manage to get a number one record in the next 6 months, I'll pay you $50,000.
I'll raise it to 100.
I'll pay you 100.
So the bet's for a number one record. But I guess when you're upset, you hear what you want to hear. And this guy has lost it.
I can move around. I'm not all fat like Ruben. I'm better looking than Clay. I definitely think so. Definitely. And you know what? I'm taking Simon's money. I will get signed in 6 months, and I will take his money.
But as we know, this is a reality show. He wasn't the only one who heard what he wanted to hear from Simon. Meet Jessica Murphy.
Jessica Murphy's the next American Idol. Woo-hoo!
How are you?
How are you?
Good.
Your name is Jessica?
Yes.
Leanne Murphy. What are you gonna sing today?
I have Whitney Houston, I Have Nothing.
Okay.
All right, sing it.
I don't really need to look very much further. I don't want to have to go where you don't follow. I won't hold it back again. This passion inside, I can't run from myself. There's nowhere to hide. Well, don't make me close one more door.
Okay. You know, when you first sing, you're very good. And then you hit those upper notes, and it all falls apart. I've got to tell you, the public are even less forgiving than we are on stuff like that. Because you have the potential, but you need a lot of work.
Yeah.
A lot of work. Yeah. For me, I don't think you're ready at all for this competition yet. I honest to God don't.
It sounds like you wear a retainer or something. There's something...
I think my mouth is dry right now.
Yeah, I think Simon's 100% right. I think, you know, you're 16. Dude, if you work really hard for a couple more years with a really good teacher, I think you could really do it.
Okay.
But it's a no for now.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Please come back.
I'm gonna cry, because I just know she's going.
Some nice feedback there. But one thing we've learned on American Idol is, it doesn't matter what the judges say, people will hear what they want to hear.
Okay. They gave me good feedback. They told me that, I'm 16 and that, wow, I have a voice like that.
You know, when you first sing, you're very good. And then you hit those upper notes and it all falls apart.
Simon, actually, that's my man right there. He told me
that I'm 16 and that I have an incredible voice. And he's like, out of everybody here, he's like, you have the most talent.
You have the potential, but you need a lot of work.
Simon said that I'm above everybody.
A lot of work.
Simon himself said she has the most talent than anyone who's here.
For me, I don't think you're ready at all for this competition yet.
They said that I have the most talent.
And then you hit those upper notes and it all falls apart.
But if I do have the most talent, then why am I not here?
She's only 16. She has just as much talent as any one of those other people that have walked out of here today.
Coming up, the next Freddie Mercury.
We are the champions.
The next Aretha Franklin.
Chain, chain, chain.
And the last chance for JP Molfetta.
I think there's a hint of desperation about you.
As the fog began to lift over the hills of the city, the second day of San Francisco auditions were about to start. The judges settled into their seats, and out in the hall, Chris Ciampi was shaking the morning chills out, hoping to get a warm welcome from the judges.
So, why are you here?
I'm here because I went to school for opera. Actually, I went to Rice University, sang on some cruise ships around the world, and gave it up for a bit and realized that I really, really missed it.
Okay, what are you gonna sing for us today?
I'm gonna do Aretha Franklin, Chain of Fools.
Let's hear it.
Okay.
Yeah, you told me to leave you alone. My father says, come on home. My doctor says, take an ACE. Oh, but your loving is much too strong. I'm added to your chain, chain, chain. Your chain, chain, chain. Your chain, chain, chain. Your chain of fools.
Wow. Oh my God.
What I'm puzzled about is the fact that you managed to get employment singing on a ship.
I did.
For how long?
6 months.
And what happened? Other than a lot of lifeboats being filled.
Simon.
No, but I'm being serious.
Simon.
Okay. Randy, yes or no?
I gotta say no, dude.
Brandy?
Paula?
No.
It's a no.
Thanks. Thanks.
Sorry.
Thank you very much.
No. The big no.
So, Chris couldn't warm the judges up with his interpretation of the Queen of Soul. Up next was Ivan Gonchev with his interpretation of the King of Queen, Freddie Mercury.
Ivan?
Yes, sir.
All right, how are you?
Very good. I'm excellent.
That's good. What are you going to sing for us today?
I'm going to sing a song by Queen. It's called We Are the Champions.
Okay.
We are the champions, my friend. And we'll keep on fighting till the end. Oh, we are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions.
Amazing how the tone of your voice is, like, close your eyes and you
just
sound
like him,
exactly like Freddie
just
Mercury.
Just like him, dude.
It's weird.
I think you are a professional karaoke singer.
Oh.
I do.
What do you mean professional? Well, is there such a thing?
Yes, somebody who's probably been to a million karaoke bars can mimic certain people, and that's it.
But if he can mimic Freddie Mercury, that ain't a bad thing.
That's not such a bad thing.
Okay, Randy, yes or no?
You know what, man? I'm gonna say yes.
Brandy?
Yes, I love the way you hold the note.
Okay, I'm gonna say no. Paula?
Yes.
Welcome to Hollywood!
Simon said, look, you must go to thousands of karaoke bars and sing karaoke, do you? Well, I do. I didn't say yes, but he's right.
Even though he was an impersonator, at least Ivan was genuinely talented. San Francisco, home to Alcatraz, and actually the first place we ever met William Hung. Rumor is they want to open the place back up and throw him in there. But he's not the only one.
So now I come to you by the moon in the sky. That's all.
every time you call my name.
All I need is you, my life. All I need is you in my life.
'Cause you went around. Oh, yes, baby. Anytime you feel like you just can't hold on, just hold on to my love.
Okay, so yes or no, Simon?
No. You'll get slaughtered in this competition.
Paula?
Not right for this competition.
So what are you looking for, then?
Which competition would it be right for?
Best in show.
Oh, God.
After one too many novelty acts, the judges were given up hope of finding a serious contender. But there was still somebody out there who never admitted defeat. Coming up, will this time be better for J.P. Molfetta?
I think that that statement is crazy.
Welcome back to American Idol. It's Ryan Seacrest in San Francisco, the last city of the auditions, and the final chance for a familiar face. Remember J.P. Molfetta? He's back. And it's been quite a journey for J.P. and his twin brother, Richard.
Our whole lives, we've been writing and recording music together. You're feeling suffocated living in your small town. We're always together. Kind of best friends, musical partners, you know, up until this point. And nothing's gonna get in your way. JP and I went to New Orleans with the idea of competing individually, got grouped together, and unfortunately, we did not make it through to Hollywood.
No. Paula?
No.
It's a no.
It's the way it works. Then I went to Vegas by myself.
Vegas!
And I wound up going to Hollywood.
JP, I'm going to Hollywood, baby!
Yeah! I'm completely, you know, hoping that he makes it into San Francisco.
Hello, John.
Hello, Simon. Oh.
So I hear you were nice about us when you left the room last time.
Really nice.
Very so complimentary.
Yeah.
Yeah? Took it well.
It was heartfelt.
Yeah. I heard that. So what are you gonna sing?
I'm gonna sing Never Keeping Secrets by Babyface.
Okay, off you go.
You know how much I care for you, and I would never wanna cause you pain. Mm-mm. Said I know that there is no excuse. How could I ever treat my baby that way? Yeah. That's why I'm telling everybody that I know I was a fool. And I don't give a damn about it, 'cause I wanna get back with you. And so I'm never
kidding. Okay.
Randy.
It was all right, dude. It was all right. Little out of tune pitch problems here and there, you know, you got some range.
Paula.
You know what I still feel lacking from you is your stage presence. I feel like you're hesitant. You're better today, I will give you that. Better today, but not good enough for me. Your brother was better in Vegas.
Yeah.
I was impressed. I really like your tone. I think you have a style about you and...
Thank you.
Simon Cowell, what say you?
I think there's a hint of desperation about you. I really do. Randy, yes or no?
I'm gonna still say no, man.
Randy?
I say yes.
Okay, Paula?
Paula, come on, man. Please. Give me that shot, I'm telling you.
I'm gonna say, based on last time I saw you to today, you made a difference, you were better. So for that, I'm gonna say yes, and if he says...
Huh?
It's no.
He says no, it's two to two.
It's no. It's no.
Dog.
You let me through in New Orleans, come on, man.
John, it's a no.
We've seen a lot better singers.
You're not good
now,
enough
man.
For this competition.
A lot of time's gone by, baby.
Let me do one more.
Joan,
on.
It's
oh,
a no.
Boy, it's four.
Joan, it's a no.
You did too, man.
All right, man.
Good looking out, though. Thanks for coming back, dog.
Thank you very much. Sorry.
It's a no. Enough. I said earlier on camera that I would jump out of one of these windows if I didn't get through. That's not gonna happen.
So JP couldn't cut it, and he won't be joining his brother Richard in Hollywood. However, 32 other contestants did make it from San Francisco. Next week on The Road Ahead, it's American Idol Boot Camp as 193 finalists head to Hollywood to battle it out for a shot at this year's title. They arrived in Hollywood full of dreams.
Hollywood, we're here!
But the judges quickly turned it into a nightmare.
I'm afraid it's a no, man.
It's a no.
The competition has ended for you now.
And as the numbers were whittled down, the tensions flared up.
I'm ready to pimp slap him.
No one's here to hold anyone else's hand. This is a competition. This isn't babysitting.
We haven't a shot in hell unless we dump this chick.
It's a week with such intensity.
I'm annoyed at all hell.
Even the judges felt the pressure as egos collide.
Say it to my face.
Simon, I don't have a problem saying anything in front of your face.
Drama.
I did what I could. I gave it my all.
Tears. And all the highs. And lows. You'd expect from the nation's number one show.
You completely compromised yourself, and you look like a fool up there.
Who has the talent to survive the tension and trauma and move on to America's vote? It's our most shocking Hollywood week yet.
She's shaking.
She needs to go to a doctor.
So be there Tuesday, 8, 7 Central. It's unexpected.
I want to go home.
It's uncensored.
I look around, it's just unfair.
And it's unbelievable.
I don't know why I flew back from London to be here, quite honestly.
As we move closer to finding your American Idol.